Are you looking for good, reliable at-home exercise equipment? Then you may want to take a look at today's video where I'm going to be doing an unboxing and assembly of the Rebuild Dip Station. Stay tuned. Hey, I'm Dale. I'm a former personal trainer as well as a best-selling fitness author. And if you want to learn a little bit more about at-home exercise made easy, make sure that you subscribe to this channel and turn your bell notifications to on so you don't miss a single video. Okay, so I just ordered the ReLife Dip Station. If you were to actually search for this over on Amazon, it is a ridiculous title to it. Actually, it's ReLife Rebuild Your Life Dip Station. Functional Heavy Duty Dip Stands Fitness Workout Dip Bar Station Stabilizer Parallette Push-Up Stand. I have a feeling that they're just trying to get more discoverability over on the Amazon platform, but nonetheless, at least I have the product that I'm looking for. I had seen this actually featured in a video with Frank Medrano. He's real big about bodyweight exercises, and I don't figure he's gonna be using any kind of messed up or bunk equipment. So I thought, you know, let's go ahead and take the dive and get this. When I ordered it, it actually was retailing for about $54.99, but it also had a instant coupon for $5 off on the Amazon platform. I'm not sure why they don't just apply that automatically, but nonetheless, if you do have Prime as well, they will ship it to you 100% free. So that part, I really like that. So this came all together to about $49.99. Not bad at all. And it got to me in a day. That's right. You didn't hear me wrong. I ordered it and it was in my hands within 24 hours. So that was pretty nice. The packaging is pretty heavy. Not gonna lie to you. If you're averse to lifting or can't lift up any kind of heavy objects, then this box is definitely gonna be pretty hefty. Now, when I actually end up constructing this and putting it together, it's fairly intuitive, but I like to double check anytime I'm doing any kind of unboxing and assembly. So this probably took a little longer than what it should have. So for instance, you see me putting the feet into place, but what I soon came to find out was it was just much easier to do 1 foot at a time. So I'm getting everything kind of put into place. You see, I'm like, yay, all right, I can go ahead and just grab the washer and the bolt and just go ahead and screw it in theory, right? Well, not really, because these aren't constructed really exactly or precise for the holes and where they're at. So it just took a lot of finagling. And I didn't get to the cursing point, but nonetheless, as I start to kind of, you know, get everything put in here, you can see it's just, I'm just fiddling around with this. So I would just recommend pay attention to the instructions. You can see now I'm just trying to put the pipe there in between, and that's when I discovered, okay, let's just go ahead and do this precisely like the instructions say. So now, as you can kind of see, I'm putting in the connector. This is actually for safety purposes, and I highly recommend you use it. I've used the ReLife Dip Station before, and I tried to do it without that connector, and I discovered real quick that it becomes a little bit more unstable. So I highly recommend that you utilize that. Here is the catch though. When you're putting in that connector, you're gonna wanna kinda unscrew the little latch first just a little bit and then push that in and then pull the latch out just a little bit so it can squeeze that connector in. But as you can kinda see, as I finally went with the instructions and actually did what they told me to do, it's working so, so much better. Everything's kinda lining up. You're gonna probably have to kind of jiggle the pipes just a little bit just to kind of get it to where the holes are perfectly in alignment. I did discover that when one of these legs, and I can't remember which one, it's a little bit off. It's a little wonky. Even when I put the connector in it, it needs to kind of have a little bit more balance on it. So again, don't expect to have anything that's scientifically put together. This is just, you know, a home workout equipment that you can utilize. And for me, it works really nice because we have a home workout gym, but unfortunately, I only have the free weights and a bench, and I have a pull-up station and cables, but the one thing I was lacking was something that I could actually do dips that was safe. Now, see, I've used chairs in the past, but Chairs are not the most reliable and most safe way to be doing dips, so this was probably the best solution. Now, you'll notice that I put it on the lowest setting. Now, I could have probably raised up a bit more. I'm 6'1", so this was more than adequate for me. I gotta admit, I could have probably moved it up, but you know, nonetheless, this worked out really nicely. Hey, if you enjoyed this unboxing and assembly video, make sure that you check out the video right down to the bottom right here. And I swear I actually do an unboxing of the Iron Gym pull-up bar. You can actually see this pull-up bar that I've used before. I'll see you there.